Great. Welcome everyone. Welcome to Healing Circle Talks. And it's been quite some time, so always good to reconnect, good to again hold this space for all of you, rather for all of us. So thank you so much. Before we begin, would like to start with the Healing Circle guidelines. Healing circles are safe havens. They are built on the foundation of kindness and respect. We all participants agree to listen to each other with compassion and curiosity. We honor each other's unique ways of healing and don't presume to advise or fix or try to save each other. We hold all the stories shared in the circle confidential, and we trust each one of us has guidance we need within us, and we rely on the power of silence to access it. So thank you so much, everybody. Today we have Suchanki Gupta with us. Whatever brief interaction I've had with her, very, very positive and vibrant personality. She is a cancer winner. She is a Hodgkin's lymphoma cancer survivor. In 2021, she started losing her energy. She was a dancer and she used to meditate a lot as well. So the loss of power was a little doubtful because she was already full of energy. She also started having fevers and night sweats on and off. She had unintentional weight loss as well. She has been prescribed some antibiotics and there was no change in her situation. Firstly, they diagnosed tuberculosis, but due to the determination of some nodules in the lungs, they sent her a biopsy and cancer was detected. She underwent surgery and chemotherapy as a part of the treatment. And Suchanki says, cancer is not a death sentence. Cancer is a blessing that is given to those who can overcome it. Be strong and talk about it and it's all good. So thank you so much, Suchanki, for being with us, for sharing your experience, your insights, your personal journey with us. And it always very, very helpful, beneficial for others who have been recently diagnosed and looking for a ray of hope, looking for some inspiration. And they draw a lot of inspiration from the wonderful stories like yours. In fact, just some time back, one of my counselors was saying that one of her patients was in stage 4 is saying that it's better to die in accident than having cancer. And then I was like, no, there are very powerful stories around us. So we need to bring those stories to those people who are in real need. So thank you, and over to you, Suchanki. Would love to hear from you about your own journey, how it all started, and thank you for being with us. Yeah,
thank you for having me. It's an honor. First of all, the first time I'm actually coming up with a story about someone in this space. And so today marks 4 years of me having diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma. Like 27th of July was the day I got to know yes, I have it. And yes, so I'll just go about how it all started first of all, and then we'll talk about things because I do not know how to go sequential about it. And no, I have to, like, after hearing stories from people, one thing I must say that nobody is alone in this. There are so many people going out there. It's so less being talked about that I want to spread awareness, like on my space, on whatever I can do. Because when I got diagnosed, I was in a shell. I was like, okay, I'm not going to disclose it. I will be private about it. I do not know why do you have to be guilty for being sick? No, you do not have to be. So then I got to know about stories of people, and then my recovery, like, of course it hasn't started yet. I'm still in the ongoing process of treatment, but I'm very hopeful. Like it'll be a change. So it's been 4 months into this, and see, here I am today. So no, it is nothing. As I have said before, Bhagwan se unhi ko wo deta hai apne best soldiers ko jo usse lad sakte hain. So aisa kuch bhi nahi hai, because I'll start. So it was the year 2021 initially, because it is a second B bulky stage of it. So I would not say it started way back. And then again, so it was in end of June, I was writing semester exams. And when I thought that, okay, so I have back-to-back exams lined up in month of June and July, and then I have done eligible for other exams also. I've like full forms for all of the exams. So, and then my university came up with all the backline exams also. I was like, why God, why so many exams happening back-to-back? But I'm glad all of that happened, because we'll get to know why. So it was in the end of June. I was at my exams for like 3 hours. I wasn't able to write 40 pages on a stretch. I realized there is something wrong, because this has never happened to me before. I was writing also, I was dancing also, I was meditating also. And then I thought it just probably the weather change, because I'll talk about symptoms also, because it is very important since you already talked all of them, but I guess a few of them are still missing. There was itchy skin also initially, which was there in the Feb end, but nobody could have comprehended back then it is something so severe, it turned out to be into cancer. So moving forward to 24th of June around, so I wrote exam, I was attempting some exam, they got over by 3rd of July, and then I actually noticed a lump over here and under my armpit. We thought probably because of the exertion I have been writing, that just said. And then I also lost my taste buds, and that was a time when corona was at the peak, so nobody would have actually said that it's something, it's anything apart from that, because taste going off taste, and on off fever, which was on like shoot, like it used to be shooting up in the night with the night sweats. I was losing on my weight, so we thought about the exams and things lined up. Also lost my appetite meanwhile, but and also the weight, everything. And there was coughing also, and then I had my exams lined up, another semester exam, once I got into the other one. So I was like, no, I have to speak to someone. So we spoke to my doctor back home, and they were like, it's because of the lung probably. No, so they gave me a normal on off, like I just took a syrup for that. And but then the lump wasn't going, okay, fever decided for a while. So I was like, all right. Then we are coming 17th of July again. So I went to a doctor in Ujjain then, because I got vaccinated on 8th of July and nobody in my family got infected. So it was definitely not corona, it was something else. So yeah, so I mean, it was all so perfect. I was like doing great. Like I was like, okay. I have been so grateful each moment of my life. I'm like, everything is going great. I am eligible for my exams. I'm studying for them. I'm dancing. I'm good off my health, my mental health. Everything is great. But like, you know, you have this intuition inside you, like there is something out there and you should always trust that. I knew something would come up, but I had no idea that it would be this. So I went to doctor on 20. I took a course for 5 days, and the doctor said in 5 days, it won't decide. Then we'll go for some tests. So on 22nd, I went to the doctor in Ujjain. So there they said the first day my NFMC there, and then they said it's tuberculosis. And so my father was like, is it curable? I'm like, Papa, huh, of course, very curable. And we got back home. Of course, we were like, for 5 months, we'll have to go for some course or something, but we'll do that. That's okay. I'm like, cool. And then they did my CBC test also. By the evening, the reports are not to be very different. Then they called up my father. They're like, Ajay, we have to speak to you. So I was like, okay. Then we went on there, because I had to write my other semester exams also after that. So I was like, you know, it's very important, because ये कभी चीजें सही हो नहीं रही हैं, फीवर आए जा रहे, क्या हो रहा है मतलब, और मतलब it's just not happening. It's just so not me. I'm not able to write my exams. What is happening? I can't like sit on a stretch of 3 hours for this exams. So yes, I realized there is something. But I was very much like, you have this intuition. So I was like, what is it? What is it, God? I knew that something is up, but clearly I had no idea like it would be this. So yes, so we went there by the evening. Like, you know, everybody had this thing. It was a kid outside. Like, I was like, I was going to the big machines. And they were, oh, of course, nobody, they didn't even ask for any of it. So we did our CT scanning. They said there are like some nodules in her lungs. So it can be probably lung infections. We were like, from TV, lung infection. All right. So all right. But then after seeing all of the CT scans report and MRI reports, doctor said that, yeah, so they said, okay, tomorrow you will have to come for an operation and it's going to be a biopsy. I was like, what sort of operation are you talking about, doctor? So yeah, so they're like, it's a very small operation, do not worry. I'm like, okay, so we can do it after a week also, once I get with my exams. I'm like, what is so urgency about it? They're like, just choose between an exam and your life. I'm like, what do you say in front of your doctor and your father? I'm like, all right, shut. And this got back home. So it was the same day, the same sequence of day. In the morning I went for NFMC, CBC, then CT scans, and by the night I'm coming home, and then I'm having my dinner. And I am so bad with this jargon and medical terms, so that I Google what does this biopsy mean, because they said it's a biopsy tomorrow. So and it says that whether that you have detect that you have cancer or not. I was okay, of course I couldn't have my dinner then. I was like, okay, we'll show them. It's definitely not cancer. I mean, come on, I'm also fit and fine. So I'll tell you guys, like the yeah. So this is one thing about cancer, you don't really know that it has happened to you, because in movies and all it shows very pop culture. They say okay, once it has happened to you, it's a death sentence. No, it is not. It never is that like that, like show in the movies. So After that, yeah. So the next morning, okay, all right. We went, everybody, like I have never seen my father this stressed in his entire life. Like he spoke doctors from Delhi to everywhere, and everyone said it has to be TB only. It was like, okay. Next morning, we went for the biopsy, but in Ujjain, they are not very good medical sources available. So they injected me with everything. They are saying that you might have cardiac arrest or problems, so you will have to refer to Indore or maybe Delhi. So I was like, okay, God. And there was same time actually, my sister also was at home with us, and it was her 9th month. So there were like things going on around, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल ही घर पे, बिकॉज ये सब चीजें ऐसे कैसे है. बट एनीवे, सो आई वेंट फॉर द बायोप्सी. माय ऑनको सर्जन वेरी वेल डिड इट वेरी नाइसली. इट ऑल वेंट गुड. एंड देन यू नो हाउ इट गोज, लाइक योर रिपोर्ट्स फ्रॉम लाइक कमिंग फ्रॉम हाई अथॉरिटी टेक्स 15 days, एंड फ्रॉम लोकलाइज इट टेक्स 4 days. सो got the biopsy done, we got back home, and of course I could not write my exam the next morning, but then somehow with the help of my friends and my sister I did it. All of that happened, and within a span, very short span of 3 to 4 days, I again went for the second opinion at Indore to my doctor, and my current onco doctor, Rakesh Tharan. Gladly, I'm very grateful I met him. It's been if you see how easily it got diagnosed in a span of 24 hours, from TB to lung infection to coming to biopsy, like it's miraculous. So I do not have any saying in it that it got to me, how it happened to me. No, of course, I got way past to it how it happened to me, because everybody wants to know that how exactly, because do not have anything so wrong in your wrong like lifestyle, nothing. But then you accept it. Okay, yes, the best thing happened to me is, I'll tell you what. So I knew from back then, something is there, something has happened, because I've been writing things and I've been like, there is something dark, something is there, and I could not comprehend what. Of course, nobody can comprehend that it's cancer, right? I'll tell you about things also. I do not know if it's just connecting the dots or not, but yes, there is a universe frequency telling it to you that yes, there is something out there. Because 8th of July, when I went for getting myself vaccinated, it was a cancer hospital, like there. And I did not see that board back then. When I checked my mail also, I'll tell you. So yes. So yeah, this is the thing. Okay, I talked about my symptoms, about how it got diagnosed, and I went for biopsy. There came 4 types of cancer in the localized report. So we want to be very sure what it is exactly. It was 27th of July. My doctor Rakesh Tharan, who is my current onco, he said that there is nothing serious. You're very young. You want to have a very good life ahead. It is there for mental satisfaction. Go to Tata once. And that's probably the best thing we could have done back then. Very next morning, it was me, my father, and my chachu. We just went there. And all of the family members came, like my relatives came over here. It was because my sister was also having her due date around, and I also had to go to Bombay overnight. So we went there, we had the appointment, and within like 10 days, I got through all of the tests. I must say Tata is doing a very, very wonderful job. It's just that one needs to have patience over there, but when I went over there, I realized it's a hub for cancer patient, be it from like a child from 2 years of age or 80 years of women, everybody wants to live. So like Sajan, you know, like you do not have any say in this. You have to be very grateful for whatsoever has happened to you, because I met people over there, and there is this one thing about cancer treatment is it people get misguided, or something or other thing happens to them in their reports and their diagnosis. And this is the key to cancer. Early detection, yes. Early detection is very, very important. So one has to be very vigilant and aware. I am not saying that I have, okay, I don't know how I'm sounding right now, because I am not that knowledgeable about it, because it just has started with me, like being 4 months into it, and the journeys are still to go on. But this is the thing, I have got to know your body is your temple. You have to know how it is happening, what is happening to you, when and what. So yes, when I reached Bombay, I went to so those 10 days. So yes, the best thing I did not mention about it happened to me was the moment I saw, okay, I have cancer on the 7th of July. I was like, okay, finally, I accepted the fact this happened to me. I got, of course, my family, my mother, my sister, everyone was expecting it has to be lung infection or something, but not cancer. But I was like, okay, I've got this for me. It's okay. Matlab, he'll find some way that is okay. You'll see me without my hair, my lashes, my brows will go. That is it. I'll recover fine. And I did that, just said. I mean, I will still be myself. I'll still be with the same heart as the same person, right? Whatsoever is gonna change. My people have to accept me the way I am. I have always been. But that's easier being done. Of course, things came up. Okay, so I went to Bombay, and all of my tests got done there within 10 days, everything. And it turned out to be classic Hodgkin's lymphoma, former of it, clearly. And so this one night, of course, my symptoms were very alarming. There was shortness of breath. There was tingling sensation in my forearms and in my feet. So, and of course, very, very bad coughing. My doctor asked me to put me immediately on chemotherapy because I would have contracted other things, in pneumonia and things. And I'm glad. So whatever happens, happens for a reason. If I look back at the things, because I had plans, I was like, okay, I'll be home. I'll be dancing. I'll be in the rain. I was like sad. I was like, damn God, why? I had plans. But I'm like, okay, they can wait, but this cannot. Glad that I did not go out in the rain and dance at that point of time. So if I look at the chain of events, I have been saved the best way. So like everything, of course. So there was this one night, because on those 10 days, I had no idea what is the severity of it. What is that? Because something's happened to me and very less known about. Yeah, cancer is a very, very, very heavy word once you hear it. But one thing I realized straightly, that we do not want pity or sympathy or anything, because it always drags us down. It just wanted to, like, people who can empathy with you. And I don't know, like, I am beyond blessed in this case. I'll tell you how. Because, yes, I realize this one thing, that I do not, thank God that I was not on the other side of it, like the person who are the person, because you are the one who's going through physically, but the people who are connected to you in the daily basis, or the loved ones, they go through on it, like they go through the same mentally also, and they are very helpless. They do not know what to do, but the best is they do not break down in front of you, because I still, like, go in respect to all my friends, my best friends who have come across to meet me, and they just give me all the power, all the strength, and my family, and that's how I'm doing it. People ask me, how are you doing it? Okay, we'll come to that, but okay, the journey of Bombay, right? So in Bombay, there was this one night where I was not able to sleep, because of course, because I had no idea on what stage I am, what it is like. So I was like, okay, what if it comes to me? But I was like, no, it's not my time yet. I'm just showing the movies. I am the hero and heroine of my life, and I take how it comes to me, and I have to do it for myself, for my family, and for the family I have. And yes, I have so, like, and yeah, in the process, you discover purpose also and everything. So one night also, I woke up at 4 and realized the purpose is to serve. I do not know how this is going to happen, but yes, to give is the purest form of thing you can do on this planet. And the life now, as I said in the previous interview also, that it's a gift. All right, so this 10 days, I got back here. They wanted to put me on chemo immediately on 6th of August in Bombay, but I wanted my mother to be around me. So I was like, no, I'll go back home only. But I was prepared. If this happens here, so I'll take it. So you just be prepared, because then, you know, God actually expends and give the best. I've told already, because God is not also, to tell you people over here, that it's been like a couple of years I've been into meditation, spiritualism and things, that I knew that there's first aid. If God has put you into something, you definitely handle it. God cannot put their child into something they cannot handle. You have to be very patient enough and put your faith. I never realized I could do any of it, because I am someone who has never ever got any syringe, any prick, anything pricked into her nerves, anything, no injection, nothing. I cannot even swallow any tablets. And see, this thing has happened to me, and I think my uncle and the people said that you're doing it very greatly. So yes, I mean, I believe in this thing. Of course, everyone has helped me in the journey, and God is there. Like, you have to have immense faith in your God, in your doctor, and in yourself, because this is something you have no idea. Yes, one thing I did was Google. Do not do that, because that's not the right place for it. I know people know all of it, but I still want to tell what has happened with me in my journey. So I got back. I got my chemo the very same day on 6th of August. Of course, then yes, I accepted the moment I saw my reports on like 27th, like, okay, this happened to me. I was like, fine. Acceptance is the best thing you can do in this thing. And a person who is strong is not someone who do not show it, not ask for any of it. Of course, because when I went for PET CT scan in Tata, you were all on your own. So there I realized I was one of the youngest person, and there were like 3-4 other people, like, and there's this room of radioactive you're being meant to set. And there I realized, okay, so this happened to me in the span of 10 days, and my life is upside down. Like when we first went to Bombay, I asked myself, well, did you want to do it? Like, it's like, of course you question things, but you should question less, because, and have faith. Less I question, more my faith increases, and more things started happening, or like falling on my side. This is what I've seen. But yes, I was very sure the intuition was there, that there is something. I was like, always my battle. And then God was like, okay, women, here it is. Go for it. Yes. So the moment it came to me, I took it. Then after coming from Bombay, in PET CT scan was the one time I actually cried. But then I told myself, okay, this has happened to you, but you will do it. And from that moment on, trust onto me. I haven't cried because I have it, because you can. Cancer, right? And then I got back here, I took my first chemo. Yes, it did. It definitely was a very weird experience, but I was happy. I was like, okay, I am still alive after the chemo. This was in my head, because we have no notions about what chemo is like. Then I met Anuradha auntie meanwhile in my second third chemo, and then I spoke to her, and then I realized, wow, like actually people who have been through this are the real superheroes. They understand you, you share the struggle. Because once I told my mom, even you won't understand what I am going through, because you know how it is like sleeping next to the dustbin and things, and feel like throwing up all the time, and nights with everything, like you full everything, there's so much of it, you cannot eat things and everything. But then you have to be grateful, because all the time I have made it to, I have kept telling myself that yes, you have come this way, a little more to Kusachanki, you have come this far, and do not ever say that you want to give it up, because no, I have never asked God that why and all of it. All I ask for is just give me willpower to face it all. And that's just how I have been doing it so nicely. Because if I see, I embrace myself, I'm like, whoa, man, like you could have done that. Like nobody who knows me believes that I could have done that. But yes, so this is how I went for chemos. Of course, things happened. Meanwhile, I also like the drug thing happened to me, because the it's basically like aapko zeher kaatne ke liye zeher dete hain, aise cheeze. Lekin we should be very grateful for 20 years back. If you look, there was no treatment for this, and it's a temporary phase. If something like this is saving your life for years, then why not go through for this like temporary pain, of course. And there's so many beautiful things about it. You grow as a person. Because how your basically your vessel will embrace, like how if you being the same person. My life has been so adventurous. There are so many side effects every other day, and I'm dealing with them. I'm like, okay, all right. So yeah, this one thing also happened with me was like, so the drug was so toxic or something happened to me that they had a difficulty finding my nerve and things while they were doing it. So then we had to go for this chemo port surgery also. That happened, but it also happened nicely. I had a follow-up in October, and my doctor said we got the response what you were looking for, so go for it. They have now increased my chemo cycles instead of radiation. That's also a very good thing, and I'm very hopeful that it get reduced at some point of time, because I'm very hopeful. Yes, I'm like, okay, I am doing my part. Hold on, how I did it all. And I told a sequential thing. My doctor said me right away, your treatment will work, what it has to work. What you have to do is stay positive and eat healthy. That is it. Of course, eating healthy, I still struggle, is something I struggle with. But before, I used to think that positivity and all this utter nonsense. What are these people talking about? What do they say? But if I have come across so far, it's because of what thoughts you are made up of. And trust onto me, not a day goes by of without gratitude in my life. And I'm very, very thankful for whatsoever, because how does it happen to you? Like on the chain of events, things went on falling my on my side. Not just that. So you have to have a very positive attitude towards it. You have to channelize it. Of course, no negativity, no toxicity. Like, okay, I'll fight it. No, it's okay. Just accept it. Accept it. Accept it. And you are not the only one in it. Since I think I spoke of another aunt, right? So, yeah. So, like, there are people out of who are entirely ray of hope. And then there's love heals cancer. And it definitely does. And I spoke of the purest form is to give. This is one purpose. That's just it. Like, so if I was thinking about my journey, so this went on like my chemo cycles and everything. Yeah. And then when friends and people got to know about it initially, Abibi, I am still not so sure. I'm like, how I'll take so much, so overwhelming. Like all the people I've been meeting in journey are so, so genuine, are like so empathetic towards everything. They keep a track of like, if how am I doing? So I am beyond blessed, honestly. So I feel like I can ever repay like this payoff, whatever like people are doing. And when we talk about caregivers, they are the ones who, without even registering their pain, actually go unregistered and they do everything day and night, because there came a time where my mother has to look for over me also, and my the newborn baby also, and she was doing it two times, like every time she was moving here, she was going there, she was doing things. Of course, I became a bit short-tempered also, meanwhile, because I have never been on bed for like so long, but chemo makes you so weak that you can't even walk. But yes, and initially I was this person, I was like, no, I don't need any help or anything, but no, it doesn't make you any less. Please reach out if you feel like, of course, you're very strong, but it's okay to ask for it, and it's very courageous, I must say that. Now I ask for things, I ask for my brother to make my bed when I'm not able to, and things, nightmares came to me, but then I started doing yoga, meditation, now I started with it also. Music helps, art helps. I told you, I went for tests, you feel like, okay, what now, because not always your reports will turn out to be on the point, but you have to accept and work on it. So yes, talk to yourself, talk to the God, and manifestation, affirmation, it is all so real. I am saying it to you. If I could have done it all, if I'm doing it all, then yes, it is all for so real. This is one life, all of us have God, and we should be very, very grateful for the same. Not just that, yes, so if people who had been through cancer, who are going through cancer, and of course will emerge victorious. So we are all, I guess, you people, everybody just is a ray of hope, surviving, like living. I mean, if they have a, like, why can't I? So, that's why it's very important to share your part of the journey, your part of the story, and I'm very, very glad. I think this is now from my side, and I would want you to take over. And yes, we'll go on.
Wow, thank you so much for sharing this. I mean, I must compliment you, you're full of energy. And when you were speaking, I was feeling like, okay, listening to you continuously. I don't know how itna zyada energy kaise aapke andar touch hua, but I'm very, very impressed with this. You said you are going to the treatment, right?
Yes, yes. That's the
why? I mean, why? You don't need any treatment. Aapke andar itna energy hai. You look fabulous, and the way you were sharing this, I was like, oh my God, she is like, kitna matlab. You have gone through the journey, you are proud of it, and you have learned from this, and you have transformed your life completely from the journey. So very, very grateful to be to witness such amazing story. I have a few more questions. So when this all happened, and I know that it comes as a, you said it's been 4 years, right?
It's been
how many years since your initial diagnosis?
4 months into it.
Yeah.
I told you I am not the one who can actually do it. But then I realized, why are we so busy planning the future? Why can't we full off in the present? One thing, and I must have missed so many things, but I must say the moment, of course, I do miss my hair and everything. But then the moment there were so many things actually missed on in the journey. We'll of course talk of, because I was like, okay, this is going in, and where am I going? And this time is also going. So yes, in the short, but I'll talk about the journey also. And to tell that all addiction is one thing, and it is not that sentence like shown in the movie. We have come so far in the chemo, in the medical technology, and everything that yes, we have for it, manifestation, everything is for real. And yes, so I always wanted to shave off my head and think, but my parents were like, no. But then when I had this thing, so we had to. So yes, my brother actually shaved off my head. And you will still be you. It's okay if things are going. You know what? You have to accept it and just go with it. I mean, nothing really matters. It's just the look. I mean, that's not the beauty. I say, okay, I have the heart. Look at it. So, no, it's not like things doesn't matter.
Okay, yeah. And usually, you know, and this is, I think, the first time when I'm talking to or interviewing somebody who has been recently diagnosed. Usually, the conversations are with people who have overcome this, who have gone through this, or the caregivers who have lost their loved ones. This is the first time, like, I'm talking to somebody who is right now going through the journey, has diagnosed, because this is the time when we face a lot of side effects. And this time, pe kafi bura bhi lagta hai. Side effects bhi bahut sare hote hain, aur samajh mein nahi aata hai ki kya kya kar rahe hain, kyunki bahut sare messages aa rahe hote hain, aur bahut sari well wishes aapko bahut sari guidance bhi de rahe hote hain. So, so what keeps you calm? What keeps you focused? I know what needs to be done. And how do you manage it?
Acceptance is this thing. I told you about this thing. Okay, so of course music keeps me very calm. Talking to friends and chanting also definitely helps very much. Like you write it down, you hear bhajans. They have worked on my part. And then also I got a time to reflect on, okay, so I needed this pause. My friends never told me you were never going to give yourself a break. So God decided to, nature decided to. It's okay. It just happened to yourself. And you're also very young. Why do you have to? So I realized things. One thing is for sure, of course, this is out of, again, more gyan than this. But yes, what kept me calm, of course, I am a very chaotic soul. I am not calm at all. I can not, never be that. But of course, during the time of treatment, it was very tough for me. Like when the surgeries were going on, they would do this and that. And up in night, it was very difficult to sleep because ek bechaini hoti hai, jiska koi tod nahi hota hai. It's just not that... it's nothing. It's just beyond. It's not even that... what do we say? It's nothing poetic, nothing you can romanticize about. It's something, it happened, and just cancer people who go into a treatment will understand that you do not know what you do, but you keep having faith. You keep telling yourself, okay, this happened to you. You have done this. Okay, it's just a little more to go. And when you look back, just tell yourself, do not give up. You have come so far. And yes, you have made it up. And always have faith in your loved ones, in yourself. If you cannot resort, not always I was okay. There were times when I actually had to ask to my loved ones to, okay, if this has happened, what do I do? When I had this chemo post-surgery also done, I was thinking last year I was dancing and doing things and today I'm not even able to move. So, but then this emotional time will only break you. It's okay. It's okay to think, but do not overthink at this point of time. Generalize your thoughts, read something, write something. And like, for I told you, this is more of a mental game and less of a physical game. So please talk it out, whatever you're feeling like. Just, and this platform I got, right? So I used to hear stories from people, and then it used to give me a lot of courage and like, okay, I can do it. Like people have been through so much, and then they have come out emerged so much. So what is it? So Janki, it's just something aise hi aaya hai, aise hi chala jayega, and see it's happening to me. Like wonderfully.
Okay, yeah, a lot of learnings in such a short time.
So much.
Yeah.
Experience this time. Like I used to hear from people and things, and I was like, okay. But now once, and I am very grateful for all of it, because I told you I got to reflect on my past life, the things that I have, this something baggage I have kept, to let out things, to be more aware about my body, to love it more, because it happens to anyone, right? It can. And then you have to regenerate yourself. You have to be positive, and positivity will take you from here to there.
Right. Very true. Okay. What is the thing that you are most grateful of during this entire journey?
This life, this is like a gift. I am grateful for my family, for my friends. And of course, I got this time. Of course, in Corona, I would not say it those last two couple of years of Corona, I wasn't grateful enough, because that taught us a lot already. But if this thing has happened to me personally, it has come for me to change. I have known now that yes, things can happen. You do not ever have to stop putting in your efforts. And this is not okay. This was the gyan I had to give, that you cannot decide the time of the things. I was this, okay, I had things planned in my mind. Okay, I'll be at these exams. And now, today what? I do not know when all of that is happening. Admit cards are coming out. But what? But I have my time now. I have my life. Things will happen on its own pace. You cannot decide the time. And you ask me for gratefulness. I am very grateful for this life and like beyond. I just want to like do things now. Like as soon as I recover, I want to like be on it. Like in whatsoever way. Just, yeah, that is gratefulness. Gratitude is something I have dived into all this journey, because of course there were lows. You asked me what kept me going. Of course, you didn't ask me a question, but you asked me what helped me. I'm just the chemo brain or the brain fucking happening to me right now. Yes, gratitude. Because whenever I'm sitting for PET CT or something, then I'm like thinking of the good times. So that's something gratitude is. I'm grateful for that. Okay, I've had this great memory with this person, with this family, with this time. I met a lot of people. Like I did not socialize so much in these 2 years of Corona, what I did in this 4 months of this journey. And all the people are back to back, be it you, be it anyone from this, be it my yoga teacher, be the doctors. In any way, I see gratitude. Of course, I was so moved when I was in Tata. I have to, like, seeing hospitals and everything, I realized, no, there is so much in this world. So I have to do things like, they all moved me so much. But gratitude, everything for this life, for this, like being able to be in this present, for being able to speak, it has always been grateful. But if you ask me something for specific, of course, your loving family, your friends who reach out to you. And yes, this is one thing I have to mention also very importantly. I guess I did not initially back then. Time. Somebody giving their time is the most valuable thing you can give to someone. Yes, so we need to be heard, and yes, everything. I'm grateful for this life, and everything I'm grateful for this has happened to me, I'm sure. Because I wanted my thing, my vessel to be like enlarged. I was like, okay, or kya. So this is a change. Like capacity, ab zyada ho gayi hai, ab hum aur le sakte hain bhagwan se. Bhagwan ne humko itna zyada isme matlab sashakt kiya, itna kuch kiya, us hisab se. Grateful hai. Because yes.
Wow, no, I love your energy, I love your positivity, your perspective towards life and towards cancer. I am hats off to you, seriously. You're going through the treatment, you have been recently diagnosed, but the kind of everything that I see is just commendable. Yeah.
Yes, also, yes, I write things and things. So this was one thing I wrote, and this has to be there in the thing that Zaria zaruri hai jang ke liye, par nazariya zaruri hai jeet ke liye. So it has to be like, we cannot change the fact that Sujanki has cancer, right? But we can definitely change the perspective that she has it. And that's how it has all worked in my favor. Yes, so far.
Wow. Okay. And what is that you want to do after you finish your treatment?
I do not want to stress on things. I just want to take one day at a time. Of course, I know it's not going to be easy for me because the soul, the person I am, I'm a paradox. Like, I'm a chaotic person. Like, I want to dissolve that also. But yes, now I need clarity. So I'm taking my time. Once I recover and everything, I'm going on some vacation. I need some change for a while. Of course, we'll go out, we'll do things, and I'll get back on my studies, which like been paused for a long now. Also, I'll dance, and I'll be more grateful with each passing day. Like, yes, and yes, like that.
Wow, wonderful. Yeah, seems like you already have things planned in your bucket list. What all you want to do? Okay, so talking about your treatment, Sachanki, can you please share what all treatment you've undergone and what all is planned now?
Yes. So no. So for me, I'll tell you. Initially, they gave me for A4 two ABVD cycles, which is like in turn out to be like they gave in a breakfast 4, and then my onco in Bombay Tata, they asked me to come for follow up in October. I went there. My body very well responded to the treatment gladly, which is not always the case. So my doctor was happy with it. But then they again increased my number of cycles instead of radio, because they feel like radio has far more long-term repercussions and things. And I was quite disappointed because when my chemo cycles increased, but then again, I told you, whatever happens for a reason. Abhi, we are not so sure it's also going to happen. I feel like I'm out of it. I already feel I'm so out of it that I am like, are we not having this for without any reason? Pakka na, matlab, aise hi to nahi de rahe hain. But of course, you have to follow the protocols. So they are now 6 chemo cycles, which are like 12 in breaks. So I got them with the 7th on 20th. I have my next planned on 4th of December. It'll be my 8th of it. And then I have to go to Bombay. And I did not say that. I was like a movie. Like, God, how on this plan? My doctor knows that I have my birthday on 15th of that, the same day. And the same day, I'm going to have my meet with my uncle. So I'm very sure, very hopeful to hear some good news from them. So I want to hear like all the good things from them. So you see, God always have this first aid, something already back. God never sent you into something you cannot handle. They endow you with a lot of power, courage, everything, and patience. I never knew I could be ever this patient in my entire life and have faith. But this is what has kept me going so far. And in my treatment, they have been AB with regimes and this chemo cycles. Radio doctor initially said they will be there, but now it's not being talked about. I'm very hopeful. Let's see what happens next.
Okay. That's really, all will go well. For sure, yeah. Lots of good wishes, love, blessings, and prayers with you always. Yeah. Okay. Would love to hear from others as well. Before that, want to hear from you, Sachanki, about your experience, your thoughts, or your about the caregiver. So for you, the caregiver was your family, your parent, your brother, right?
Yes. Like I told you, it's not just you who go through. Like there have been like small things. Like of course, I told you, like nobody ever broke down in front of me. But then 3 months now, I got to know that my mother had this thing in her mind back initially, but then she never showed it. That it was a difficult time for like seeing both her daughters going something because things were not going so good on my sister's side also at that point of time. But then gladly now I became a Masi meanwhile. And to have a newborn baby in your home is a blessing. We never stop celebrating any of the function. I think that's what kept us going. I'll tell you, yes, the best days. The best days have been the days where I'm not being reminded there is something. Glad to my friends and everybody. Nobody really talks of it. Like, okay, तुम ठीक हो और तुम और ठीक हो जाओगी. इससे अच्छा क्या हो सकता है? But they were like very very low days, but then they were always some hope. Always, you know, you have to look for the silver lining, and this has all happened with a positive attitude. And you have to challenge yourself. You will have to do it. It's not easy. It's easy being sad, but this is what helps you out. And with, yes, so yeah, like my father was like, I said, don't have to take off or anything. Like, don't make me feel like there is something has happened to you. So we did nothing special, anything. We just kept the normal life going. Eventually, that was difficult, but yes, we did that. And I'm very grateful, like very grateful. Whosoever used to come to my place, we have been having people over our home, and it's been great. Like my friends have been coming. It's been so good. Like beyond, I'm very, very genuine, like very genuine people. I see out and everybody's like, yeah, people have been very empathetic. That's I'm something very, very grateful for. And with the caregivers, oh my God. So if my entire family started sleeping with me once I started having the nightmares. So yeah, I mean, of course, we have all adapted to this change, but I'm sure we'll be back to the normality very soon. So yes, without understanding their pain, their things, they have been working, walking, doing things, they have been wanting things. And of course, I did have some short temperness meanwhile, because I told you, like I had things lined up, and then I realized, Sachanki, no, you cannot plan everything. It's not in your hand. All you can do is put in your efforts. Things will happen on its own pace, on its own time. There was something difficult for me initially to admit and accept, but once you say things to yourself, it starts working that way. That's how it has analyzed this entire thing in my life.
That's very this true. Is how- yeah, very true. Thank you so much for sharing this, Shanki. So we'd love to hear from others as well about their experience and their feelings, their thoughts about the circle, about your journey. Many of them already know you. I can see from their expressions. So yeah, and Radha ji.
Hi, Suchanki.
Hi.
So nice to hear.
मुझे
तो सुचांकी की वही बात याद आती कि कुछ भी तकलीफ होती थी तो फिर इसके फ्रेंड कहते ले तेरी अनुराधा आंटी को फोन लगा ले, लाइक है ना. सो चार्मिंग. अब पहली बार जब मैं सुचांकी से मिली थी और आज की जो सुचांकी है उस की थी और आज की जो सुचांकी है उसके लिए so much love. You are so confident. Itna acha lag raha hai tumko sunke ki main bata nahi sakti. That's all.
Bhar jayega waqt ke sath. Karishma aap bhi to dekho, sab hai sab ke sath acha acha hota hai.
Bilkul.
Thank you so much.
Sab acha hi hona hai. Ha, aur sab achhi ho jaogi, mujhe pata hai na.
Definitely. Mehul, would you like to share?
Hi Suchanki. I am so I cannot breathe now. I'm so into that flow of yours. But I do not want to give any gyan to you because you receive so much of gyan from so many people. I am a cancer survivor, so do you have any questions for me?
Yes, I mean, no, I have of course known you. I have come for, like, I have been part of the Saturday sessions already, so many. I know so much already. I see it. I just, of course, like, mine got detected very, very soon. We can't even compare to that of yours. But you have come up, it also has helped me a lot. No, I keep on checking. Okay, so fourth grade has happened to him, and now he's having a life that too overseas. Wow, Suchanki, cheeze hoti hai jeevan mein. Jab kuch nahi hai, nothing has like ended over here. It's a very new beginning. Look for it. Ho jayengi cheeze. Very, very good. Achha lagta hai, like, jaan ke sab. Feels good.
Yeah, but one thing I would like to applaud, like, you know, the way process and way you think track, and I'm confident you will overcome this much before than expected. Just keep focused, and yeah, you are doing everything that needs to be done, and keep the charm, you know, increasing day by day. We are all with you. If you need anything, feel free. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Mehul and Arjun, or Arjun's family. Would you like to share anything?
Hi, Parisha. Hi. Hi, Arjun. These are the people I spoke to in the morning because I had a very bad fatigue and vomiting sensation. Everything happened to me. I was on my bed. I was like, how would I do it? But I was like, come on, Sujanki. Why Sujanki? Sab ho jaate hai. Itna kar liya toh sab bhi ho jayega. And now I'm here.
Wow.
I was very skeptical about asking my friends to come over. I was like, I'm not too sure how is it going to be. Like, the first time I'm ever going to be open about it. And it's been 4 months. But I knew every story meant to be heard. I have no idea how it would even inspire, but I just wanted to let it out for, like, okay, it makes me feel good.
Arjun, would you like to share anything? आपकी आवाज बहुत धीरे आ रही है, हम सुन नहीं पा रहे हैं, तो आप थोड़ा सा माइक को पास में रख के बात करिएगा।
नहीं, हमारी तो बात होती रहती है वैसे चंकी से, पर बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है इसको ऐसे देख के, इतना कुछ देख के, और धीरे धीरे रिकवर हो रही है, बहुत बढ़िया लग रहा है। और वैसे भी हम थोड़े दिनों में इससे मिलने वाले हैं।
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Most of my friends are getting to know. We've just been there second for like 6 months and everybody wants to meet. So I realize this one thing, they are very good people out there and world loves you. People loves you. We know people are out there who are careful. Initially, I asked my parents, I'm like, nobody loves me, nobody loves me. Oh God, the world does care.
Wow.
They are silent fishers. They are people out there. Like, these are my friends. They are my friends who have come for surprise visits from far places. So I am beyond blessed and grateful for all of it. Like, I have no reason to be sad or anything if I see. I mean, yes, I do not think it's been a fun or something the entire journey, because I've seen lows and my people have gone through so much. I told you, it's a mental game more. Your loved ones also go through so much. But with togetherness, we all overcome it.
Yeah, and you have wonderful friends. I mean, you know what? Because of all this, you know, your great family, your wonderful friends and people, community like Anuradha Aunty and many others, it's a combination of everything that has been working out very well for you and your own willpower and positivity. So keep it up, and thank you, Kapil and family, for being there for her. She is lucky. Yeah.
Both favorite kid, I have been having this tagline because everything comes out to be true with anything. So now I'm like, I'm gonna manifest the best in my life, and yes, it come to me.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. Would love to hear from Kapil. Hi, Kapil.
Hi.
Yeah, would you like to share anything for Sujanki?
Yes, ma'am, actually, I'm a lymphoma patient.
Achha.
No, from Parai. हेलो
हाँ कपिल, आपकी आवाज आ रही है। आपने बोला कि आप भी अभी लिम्फोमा पेशेंट।
मैं इंदौर से ही हूँ।
अच्छा।
मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा सुचंकी को सुन के। मैं बहुत होपलेस था, बल्कि इनको सुनने के बाद काफी एनर्जी मुझे फील हो रही है। मैं शुरू में बहुत मिसगाइड हुआ हूँ। एक्चुअली मैं इंदौर के पास एक छोटे से विलेज से बिलोंग करता हूँ, तो वहाँ मुझे इतना अच्छा सेम है, मेरा भी टाइमिंग वही है। मतलब मैं भी लॉकडाउन में, मुझे कुछ पता चला था मेरे बारे में, काफ़ी कुछ चल रहा है मेरी लाइफ में भी, बट सोचूंगी तो सुन के मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा। मैं चाहूँगा कि उनसे कॉन्टेक्ट में रहूँ।
राइट, एंड कपिल, लॉट्स ऑफ ब्लेसिंग्स एंड लॉट्स ऑफ पावर टू यू to go through this journey, and I've just shared our number with you. Agar aapko kabhi bhi kuch bhi help chahiye, so Chanki se kisi bhi, I'm sure aap log already connected honge, nahi to hum connect karwa denge. And
pehli baar suna hai
na? Acha, okay, right. So theek hai. So but haan, jaise ki aapko pata, aap dekh hi rahe hain yahan pe kaafi stage 4 survivors bhi hain, kaafi 3 time cancer survivors bhi hain. Chanki to bhi journey se nikal rahi hai aapki tarah. and a lot of things that acts together to heal the person, to cure the disease, and it's all gonna be fine. So and you up is flat up your circle mein aaye, apne apna khud ke bare mein bataya. It's all the positive energies combining together, working in the same direction. So you're already part of this entire this jo hoti hai na, ek energy jo hoti hai, ek jo vibes hoti hai, ki the vibes of positivity, the vibes of ki haan hum karke dikhayenge. Aap already uska part ho gaya. I'm sure ki sab kuch theek ho jayega. So aap bas strong will power aur kuch bhi help chahiye, bahut hi badi community apni, aur koi bhi aapko hamesha help karne ke liye ready rahega. So anytime you can connect. Yeah. Yeah, Kapil, take care, and yeah, you can connect with me also after this. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, Nandini wanted to share something. Just a second. Yeah, hi, Nandini.
Hello.
Hi. Is it possible to start your video?
Yeah. Am I audible now?
Yes, you're audible.
Okay. I'm a friend of Suchanki, like way before, like school kids. And it was this timing that I got to know that. And the thing is, what I love about all this, like, I obviously there's nothing to love. I mean, her commando mode on, you know, all the her fighter zone on, and like the way she owns her situation. So Changi, like, too much power, too much wishes, man. You know, I'm like the most, I'm so proud of her. I'm so proud of Sushanki here. I am no survivor. I'm no patient. But the closest thing to this is one of my aunt. She was a cancer survivor, stage 3 breast cancer. That was the closest thing I've seen. And now I have my friend Sushanki here. And all I can say is I'm super proud of her. And all the people actually. And it is only through her I got to know like so many people, and it is something inevitable and unpredictable. You cannot see this coming, and it quite scares me. Like, you know, brings these strings, like it gives me goosebumps. Ki kab kisko pata chal jaye? They never know. All what I loved about Suchanki when she said like acceptance is the core, very has so much importance. It is so much important to accept it. And then deal with it, put in all your efforts, be positive and all. Like that's what it was actually good that I joined in and I got to listen to her and other people's experiences. So that's what I wanna say.
I do love you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yes, I did not know how many friends can you bring on. So I was like 5 to 6, I was very skeptical. I was like,
thank you.
Dimple for giving this platform. Like, I'm very grateful. Like, I get to speak to my thing, and yes, we'll add on things. We'll keep on doing that.
Definitely. So, yeah. I mean, it's you whose aura, whose energy is bringing all of us together. So thank you, Suchanki. And we'd love to hear from Saloni. Would you like to share anything?
Yeah. Am I audible?
Yeah.
Hi, Suchanki. I got to know her yesterday and we had a conversation. And I just can't explain how confident she is, how positive she is. And I was so amazed that a girl like her, she is so young and she's, you know, giving me so much courage that the koi baat nahi, aa gaya hai to chala jayega. I'm so grateful for my life. Even I learned so much from her. And she's really a very beautiful soul. I'm so happy that I got to know her. And she's very confident. I don't know how to explain her in words. Like, she's so beautiful, and she even looks beautiful like this also.
Yeah. Just beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. I keep on saying, like, God makes you meet beautiful people inside out. Like, if you look, if you like, it just happens to you. Agar aap acche hai, to sab acha hai, jagat hai. And see, this is happening with me. I'm getting to know the Dimple, to you, to Mehul ji, to Anuradha ji. All of us, we have connected. And immense, immense respect to everyone, whosoever is a caregiver, whosoever is going through it. We are all in it together. Like, more and more people. Thank you.
कोई और कुछ शेयर करना चाहेगा? Okay. So Suchanki, what is that one word, one line that you want to share for all the people who are currently going through this disease?
I would say who are currently or who actually like whosoever is been through like already very much immense and everything, whosoever is going through it, I think just have the faith and जीवन संघर्ष है, बिना संघर्ष के तो कुछ भी नहीं है, ये बात तो सच है और इसे मानना पड़ेगा. लेकिन भगवान अपने सबसे ज्यादा जो सबसे चाहिए बच्चे नहीं होते लाइक आई एम वाज लाइक ओके मेरा ये नाम है ये चीज तो कुछ तो अच्छा होना ही चाहिए, अब और लगता था देखिए अब ये भी हो गया तो वही लाइक हैव दिस अप्रोच और हो जाएगा. लाइक हैव इमेंस फेथ ऑन योर गॉड. लाइक yes god will never put into you in a situation which you cannot get over or get through like to accept to get through and you will make it. Just keep on going. Yes, I mean manifestation, affirmation, positivity is one thing, have faith in a doctor and everything, and ye to sari cheeze, this is a very very important outlook towards it, but medical sciences also we cannot keep them apart. Please, like if you feel like there is something, like do not be every day that there is something, be vigilant and aware about yourself ki, okay this happened to me, not negate things for long, because that's something we actually, yes, power of attraction, hold on to it and we all will agree to it because we've been through it and we have made out through it, so we actually stick in the same thing. Yes, this is one thing, and yes, I mean everything goes hand to hand together, but supreme power you have to, because वही भगवान अपने सबसे अच्छे बच्चों को ही ये देता है, लाइक द बैटल टफेस्ट बैटल दे पुट इनटू, और फिर आप एकदम बिल्कुल बिल्कुल निखर के निकलते हो इस चीज से, लाइक यू विल ऑलवेज गेन समथिंग आउट ऑफ इट, लाइक टेक इट लाइक अ लेसन और समथिंग, लाइक इट हैज हैपेंड टू मी, ओके एक्सेप्ट इट एंड नाउ लाइक वन ईयर टू थ्री ईयर डाउन द लाइन विल सी, राइट नाउ ऑल्सो ग्रेट थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग टू मी, एवरी डे इज अ ब्लेसिंग, यू वेक अप यू आर इन द ग्रेटिट्यूड, लाइक ओके यू गेट टू सी द डे एंड यू आर ऑल वेल, एंड देन देयर आर थिंग्स बीइंग स्पोकन अबाउट, बट आई विल से अगेन बहुत सारी इनका तो लाइफ टाइम क्योर चलता है. कैंसर इज समथिंग यू कैन ओके सो डॉक्टर्स अराउंड मी केप द पॉजिटिविटी, दे वर ऑलवेज सेइंग कि इट्स अ इट हैज अ वेरी गुड प्रोग्नोसिस, इट्स अ गुड क्यूरेबल रेट, सो दैट्स ऑल समथिंग. जस्ट हाइप अप पीपल विद द गुड थिंग्स, लाइक जस्ट डू नॉट पुल देम डाउन, सब अच्छा अच्छा होगा, जस्ट कीप अप मेंटेन इट एंड एक्सेप्टेंस, लाइक द मोर द सूनर यू डू इट the better you go with it, because that's how I have been doing from day one. The moment I got to know four months back, I was like, okay, this happened to me and we will do it without a fight. Like, okay, you have cried, it's okay, now get up. Ho jayega. To bas, waisa hi hai, chalega.
Thank you. Wonderful, Sujanki, great thoughts. And I after hearing your journey, there's a poem that comes to my mind and I want to speak it for you. I dedicate this to you, and the theme is courage. Courage to speak up, courage to stand up, courage to say yes, courage to say no, courage to make a change, to view something in a new light, courage to let go, courage to go after, courage to start and courage to end, courage to walk away, to sit still, courage to grow, courage also to stop. Everything begins with courage, and I really, really admire your courage. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dimple.
Yeah, thank you so much, everybody, to join this session with Sujanki, and very, very inspired. And again, I'm full of energy after talking to you. So yeah, and really grateful to each one of you for holding this space for all of us, and our prayers and best wishes to Sujanki, Kapil, and many others who are going through this journey. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you, Mahadev ji. Yeah, Mahadev ji, we couldn't hear you. आप कुछ बोलना चाहेंगे अभी? Okay. ठीक है. Thank you so much. Thank you. Really appreciate it. Bye, everybody. See you Saturday 5 p.m. Thank you.
And thank you so much.